following is a special presentation of ABC Sports.
Football's coming on tonight. So get ready. I mean, get ready. Are you ready for football? For Monday night party? Yeah, this is old Hank, and I'm back, and I'm ready to get this thing started. So put the teams on the field and get them pumped up right. Well, all my rowdy friends are back for Monday night. Great teams and all the big names, from the steel curtain to two kids called Joe. Even Johnny U played on this show. We've seen the perfect pass and the race and back, the TV dive and the nasty sack. The best of all played on ABC. What we got here is a dynasty. Friends are back for Monday night. Yes, everybody is a fan. This is the biggest party, man. We got friends in Adam and Dan. They're gonna get it kick-started. Quentin and Lynn are all set. It's the time that is right. All my rowdy friends are here on Monday night.
When we last left the 1995 Sherwood Warriors, they were Maryland State 4A champions. The 96 Warriors knew that repeating as champs was the hardest feat in sports. Every team was gunning for them. And there was nowhere to go but down. They started the season without a home, but they never lost sight of their mission. Just do it again.
This is a team to beat again this year, the Sherwood Warriors, one of the best teams in the area. We'll follow.
16 starters returning and a very talented supporting cast. The Warriors are the definite team to beat this year, and they loom as the preseason favorite to make it back to Bird Stadium.
They're a very conscious group, so they're not going to change a whole lot.
I'm going to Disney World.
You're going to kick butt?
Yeah, I'm going to Disney World.
Okay, guys, we all be ready for the football.
Sports Illustrated said he's one of the best 25 high school football players in America. But he says, don't put it all on me, folks. We got a lot of talent on this team.
Thank you.
you ready for some football?
The 1996 Sherwood Warriors.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Schedule-wise, the Sherwood Warriors had it rather easy to begin the season, as their opponents went a combined 9-27. But the second half of the year, it could be a different story for Sherwood.
Yeah, we've played really well in our opening games, but now we're definitely going to be in the heart of the schedule and start playing tougher teams, and we'll find out how good we are.
They're undefeated on the year and seem well on their way to another state title. Sherwood hasn't been challenged yet this season. They are winning their games by an average score of 38-3, and despite all the preseason hype about the offense, it's been the defense that has led the way.
We had a lot of starters from last year, so we knew our defense was going to be perfect. And it's been holding up good, very good. And me and Graham just been playing our hearts out on defense.
They're going to hit the meat of their schedule starting right here on Friday night against Springbrook.
A team of this quality and this caliber. They're a fantastic team, maybe the best team that Montgomery County's ever put out.
For Sherwood, it's a short week of practice and then their toughest test of the season, Friday night at undefeated Gaithersburg. We'll be right back.
couple things we know away, and that really helped us out. They're a great team. We'll probably see them in 2 weeks, most likely. And, you know, things should get went either way this game. They play a real fine game, and I'm really excited. Number one in the state, baby.
We had a lot of penalties and a lot of mistakes, and it's really hard to come back, but we have made a good effort in the second half, and a few more mistakes on the kickoff, but we played well. We'll probably see them again.
A great high school football rematch. The highlight of the regular season featured a memorable tug of war between Seneca Valley and Sherwood. The Screaming Eagles took the game by 7 and won the 4A title along with it. Tomorrow they will meet again in the state semifinals. Now, beating Sherwood once is tough enough, but to win twice is asking a lot.
You know, everybody fighting for this one. You know, it's like you said, it's here at our school, you know, our hometown. We got our home fans now. Ain't nothing else to worry about.
We still got to pay Sherwood back because they beat us twice last year, and we're going to be ready. It's the biggest game of our life, and everybody's ready. We've been waiting for this ever since last year. We knew it was going to come down to this. We knew the path of Bird had to go through Sherwood, so we're going to be ready.
Seneca Valley at 11-0, and the 10-1 Warriors kick off tomorrow night at 7:30.
But this thing was not even close, folks. Sherwood has a plant, a small shrub on Seneca, 37-0 the final. Warriors now move on to their second straight Class 4A championship game, while Seneca goes home with their first loss of the year. We go out to Seneca Valley here where the Screaming Eagles came out of the gate all fired up in this thing. Opening drive, Sherwood marched downfield. Finish it with a Tyree Foreman run from 4 yards out. Tyree Foreman was the story in this game. 7-0 Sherwood, 6:35 opening drive. Second quarter, more Foreman over the right side. How good is Tyree? 17 yards on that run, untouched. Sherwood up 12-0 at the half. Best Foreman run. Watch this thing. Outstanding. Gets the pitch, does Tyree. Three cuts. Zig, zag, zig. Back to the far sidelines for Tyree Foreman. That is flat out a thing of beauty right there. Third quarter, more Foreman. There's a trend to this, huh? This time from 9 yards out for Tyree. The big players, they play big in the big games. 19-0 Sherwood. Foreman played big. 4 touchdowns for him. Still in the third, Lamon Daniels, the sophomore, getting in on the act. 18 yards. How about you, Lamon? The route is on. 25-0 Warriors. Best run by someone not named Foreman. It's senior Damian Miggins. You think you got him? Guess again. Miggins slipping tackles. Down the sidelines he goes. 27 yards, and that play typified Seneca's whole evening. Sherwood finished the scoring here in the fourth. Travis Vaughn, the quarterback, man, he had his troubles all day. Looking far side, threw it to the wrong team. That's Foreman again, and folks, that's another touchdown. He can play defense, Ken Tyree. There he is on the interception. 45 yards on the touchdown. Sherwood gives Seneca its only loss of the year. 37-0 was the final. Sherwood moves on to the state finals. They'll play Roosevelt in the 4A title game on Saturday night. Sherwood's second straight trip to the state.
They're a great team, and they had a great season. And we just had to come out and try to knock these guys off, and we just got it done tonight.
Oh, it feels great. I mean, the whole team's so excited. This is just a great way to end my senior year, going back to Bird Stadium for another state championship.
A little disappointed they handled us as well as they did, but, you know, sometimes that things happen. You know, we've been on the upper hand of some good butt whoopings, and this time it was our turn. So, you know, we'll just take it and go on from here.
They have a terrific team. I mean, they're 11-1, and we beat a great team. That's what you feel so great about. They're a really, really good football team. And, you know, we felt last time that if we didn't beat ourselves, you know, we were maybe the better team last time. And, you know, this time we didn't beat ourselves, and we won the game.
All right, so Bob Malloy and the Sherwood Warriors now move on to the 4A state title game. They'll take on Eleanor Roosevelt on Saturday night at 7 o'clock in Byrd Stadium.
A great win. That was a really good football team. They were, Roosevelt was really good and well prepared, and you know, we had the flu all week long. Every practice we had 10 guys out, and it took its toll on us. And not taking anything away from Roosevelt, but you know, I give these guys a lot of credit.
It still is great because in past years we haven't been too well in football, but since Malloy came, he's turned our program around. It feels good to be up there with the Springbrook teams and the Annandale teams from the metro area.
Twice as nice. My senior year, you know, who knows if this might be the last time I ever play football. Who knows? But this is the way I wanted it there.
This is definitely a personal victory for a lot of the seniors since it was their last game, and a lot of the coaches. We had players graduating on this team, so it feels good.
Oh, it's unbelievable. I mean, going out with all the people, I mean, our team's just like a family. I mean, we got a lot of coaches' sons. I mean, it's unbelievable to go out like this.
Each day I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this
the 1996 Sherwood Warriors, Maryland's